CompTIA ITF Plus Complete Training Course. Exam Objective 3.6, Compare and Contrast General Application Concepts and Uses. Software Installation. The process of installing software can be broken down into some common steps, the first of which is to read the installation instructions. This will cover important topics, like is the software compatible with your operating system, or does your current hardware support the program and meet the minimum RAM, processor, or hard drive requirements. After reading the installation instructions and verifying your system can operate the software, the next step is to download the software from the installation media. Software installation media refers to the physical or digital means by which software is delivered and installed onto a computer or device. Installation media transitions software from a collection of digital instructions into a functional application. Installation media can come in various forms, such as CDs, DVDs, USB drives, or downloadable files from the internet. But once it has completed its task, the result will be an operational program that can be used by the computing device. Next, depending on the software product, you are likely to need a product key. These product keys are like digital passports that grant access to specific software applications. Much like a unique fingerprint, each product key is distinct and serves as a verification mechanism to ensure that users have acquired legitimate and authorized copies of the software. Acting as both a security measure and a licensing control, a product key is typically a combination of letters, numbers, or characters, separated by hyphens, that users enter during the software installation process. This key unlocks the software, enabling its full functionality. Another part of the software installation process involves agreeing with the EULA. A EULA, or End User License Agreement, is a legally binding contract between the software creator or publisher and the end user of a software application. Operating as a virtual rulebook, the EULA outlines the terms and conditions that govern the usage of the software. Comparable to a set of guidelines for navigating a digital landscape, the EULA specifies important aspects such as permitted usage, restrictions, intellectual property rights, liability limitations, and any obligations or responsibilities of both parties involved. By agreeing to the EULA, users acknowledge and accept the rules under which they can utilize the software. The last part of the software installation process I will explain is the difference between the default and the advanced installation option. Starting with the default installation option, this option is designed to offer an express and hassle-free approach to installing software. Comparable to following a well-marked path, a default installation takes care of the essential steps, making it ideal for users seeking a quick and straightforward setup. However, for those who wish to take their software experience a step further and customize it to their specific needs, advanced options come into play. These custom options provide users with the ability to fine-tune various aspects of the installation process. This includes selecting specific components or features to install, choosing where installation files will be placed, adjusting performance settings, and even modifying the user interface. Be sure to pay attention to each of these software installation steps next time you install a program. Maybe even take a peek at the advanced installation options. What could go wrong? Thank you for watching. Subscribe for more great content.